The following review is rated A for adult content. You should be 18 or over to watch this show. ADTV comments do not reflect the views of Knox Pro Entertainment or any other federation.
Hey, this is the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, and check out ADTV. If you want to know all the action, if you want to hear about all the scoops, if you want to know what's happening in the world of crazy professional wrestling, check out ADTV. It's unbelievable, baby!
Welcome back, fans. Another edition of ADTV. Raw was awesome! Wow! 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 What a fucking ending to a beautiful edition of Monday Night Raw. Are you serious? The Miz cashing in the Money in the Bank, beating Randy Orton after the Nexus and him were working his fucking right knee all night long. That, my friends, is how you again properly cash in the Money in the Bank briefcase. I thought the Miz was gonna lose. I really did. I predicted he's gonna be the first one to lose, but they fucking proved me wrong. Awesome job! Wow! Whew. Man, I just can't get over the excitement. I'm sure a lot of you fans hate The Miz. A lot of you fans like it. It's kind of 50-50, kind of like with John Cena. So, interesting that they put the belt on him here and Cena leaving. Kind of interesting. All right, fans. Of course, we all know how the show is going to start. We're going to do things a little different, but before I get to that, winner of our contest. Now, this is how we did this. We basically, got all 143 or so subscribers. That's 143. We put on a Word document. We chopped it all up. Put all the individual pieces in the freaking washer. Put it in the dryer. Freaking tumble dried that shit on low heat. Pulled it out. Threw it on the floor, on the carpet. And all of a sudden, bam! Like a thief in the night, J.A. were the first initials. And no, it wasn't Jackass or J.A. Adonde. No, it was fucking Johnny Awesome 24, baby. You are the motherfucking winner. You didn't win the Wrestling Revolution contest, but guess what? You are the winner of this contest. Now, K-Ross will have a special, I'm sorry, Hebrew Heat, whatever. He will have the results for you. This coming up SmackDown on the review. Now, fans, as I said earlier, the show's a little different. We're going to do things as the top five highlights and the top five lowlights. Now, as we all know, I like to start things off on a positive note. So, fans, let's go with the top five highlights. Coming in at number five is Sheamus beating R-Truth. Yes, he did lose to Morrison last night, but now he's in the King of the Ring qualifying match. In the tournament now. He won the match, good short match. R-Truth got some offense. Again, decent match. All in all, Sheamus wins with a fucking awesome bicycle kick. I mean, he hit him flush. They call it the grunge kick or whatever it's called. Then he hit the Celtic cross, carried him all across the ring, then hit it. Boom, match over. Awesome. Now, coming in at number four. What about that Lay Cool promo with Natty backstage, actually in the parking lot? Oh my lord. Natty's like, I don't know who these girls are. Is McCool, is that M-A-C-O-O-L? A security guard was funny. I mean, that was a cool little bit to keep them out of Raw. And the match with her and Alicia Fox and Natalya, again, beautiful work, short, sweet, to the point. Natty wins. I like it. I like where they're going with this. I can see a match with her in the Shirazan, of course, the princess of fucking wrestling. That would be a beautiful match to have. Now, coming in at number three is, the King of the Ring tournament next week. Of course, after we already have, and of course, the King of the Ring tournament on the Raw side is going to have Sheamus, Ezekiel Jackson, Daniel Bryan, and John Morrison on the Raw side. Now, SmackDown, of course, will have four competitors as well, and the new King of the Ring will be announced on the next week's three-hour Raw. This is awesome! I mean, they're just coming off of just beautiful. WWE's just on hit right now with their shows, their booking. Some of the stuff, yes, there are some bad ones, but all in all, they're just on fire right now. Now, well, of course, the last two matches of the Survivor Series pay-per-view, but we all know that fucking blue. Let's see here. What have we got next? Well, anyways, yeah, let's talk about the King of the Ring real quick here. Who do you think is going to come out on top? Now, I, on the Raw side, would love to see Morrison come out on top of this. Because he, after beating Sheamus, can really, maybe he'll have a rematch with him in the semifinal. Maybe it'll be him versus Sheamus in the final, since they're both in it on the Raw side. Now, on the SmackDown side, I can see possibly Alberto Del Rio, or Alberto Dorito, getting himself, you know, maybe in the finals as well. Big Show's in there. I see Cody Rhodes as a possible, or Drew McIntyre as a possible dark horse as well. All right, now, again, it's going to be a great show next week. I'm really looking forward to it. Number two, Punk on commentary. Now, for the time being, of course, he's still resting up from his injury. He should be back probably in a couple, maybe a month or two is what I'm thinking. So for now, we have another three-man booth on Raw, in addition with the three-man booth on SmackDown. Unfortunately, Cole's on both shows. But now to make Raw more interesting, we have another heel commentator that blows Jerry Lawler the fucking chain. Oh my God, was Punk on fire tonight. Wow. Again, positive, good stuff out of what's coming out of the WWE so far. And the number one thing, of course, awesome. Miz cashing in at the right time, right after, you know, Wade Barrett of the Nexus did a number on Randy Orton. Came in at the right, precise moment after last night, kind of teased it. You know, when he came out with the briefcase after the Daniel Bryan match with DiBiase, you know, came down and cut the promo, you know, LeBron James, so people were wanting him to cash it in then. But no, out of nowhere, he cashes it in. Good job. And the best part was when Cena came down and left, that means you knew Cena wasn't going to come in and interfere. Nexus was gone, so it was just him and, you know, his lackey, what's his name? I don't even know his fucking name at this point, his lackey. Alex Riley, there it is, A-Rye, which again, Punk was beautiful and I call him A-Rye. I mean, he's a little stale, he said, which was actually pretty cool as well. So again, those were the highlights of Monday Night Raw. Now, let's get into the lowlights. Number five, of course, was actually Morrison beating Tyson Kidd. Here's why I didn't like this, because it was too obvious. Granted, I like the fact that they gave Tyson Kidd the opportunity to actually be in the Money in the Bank qualifying, you know, to actually maybe be in the tournament, but come on. After Morrison beating Sheamus last night, clean in the middle of the ring, did anybody have any doubt in their mind what was the end result of this match was going to be? Really? Really? That's why I didn't like it. It was a decent match, don't get me wrong. Good moves. I mean, good stuff. But, you know, I just didn't need that match. All right, let's go in at number four, which was another match that kind of buried somebody else again, which is Daniel Bryan beating DiBiase. Now, actually, this is where I like to have seen DiBiase, you know, be in the Money in the Bank. Oh, not Money in the Bank. Wow. King of the Ring fucking tournament next week. This would have been a huge opportunity, but they kind of dropped the ball again. Daniel Bryan already has a championship. He's already your IC champ. Morrison is trying to, you know, get his own, you know, push right now. I don't see this, you know. I don't like where they're going with this. They're just burying DiBiase, and it's just getting worse and worse every single week. Excuse me, coming in at number three. What's up with Santino and that whole promo backstage with Kozlov and Tamana and the fucking hermaphrodite kissing him? Playing a fucking banjo. What is she, like fucking Eric Bischoff? I mean, come on. This was like that. I didn't like it. But what was kind of interesting was they did the old hat trick tonight. You know, they had actually three divas, you know, going after guys. You know, Molina backstage with Morrison, slapping him on the ass, which was kind of interesting at least. Maybe they'll get back together on camera. And of course, what was the other one? What was the other one? It's not coming to me. Oh yes, of course, the Bella Twins. First it was Brie Bella coming down during the walking with Daniel Bryan during the ring entrance during this match. And the second was when Brie Bella came in. And they both were like fighting over him. He's like, no, you guys just kiss and make up. Again, now that Linda McMahon's not in Congress anymore running for Senate, not until next year at least, maybe they're going to ease up in this whole PG thing, you know, maybe. But coming in at a, I'm going to throw this all in at 2 and 1, because it's kind of two separate things in one. The whole thing I didn't like about the beginning promo of the show, okay? Why would Wade Barrett, okay, after firing John Cena, allow the motherfucker to come back? Granted, the promo that Cena cut, gotta admit, it's pretty fucking cool. I hate the motherfucker, but wow. That could have been a straight shoot. Vince could have said, hey, go out there, you know, just pump up the crowd. I don't know. But that could have been a shoot there. But where was I getting at? Oh, yes. I like the fact that he also, it was too obvious. Let's have a main event match between you and Barrett and Randy Orton for the title later on in the night. Again, that's too predictable of a booking here. It made no sense. We allow Cena to come back. You knew that Cena was going to come in during the main event and cost the match, because it's Cena's last night there anyways. So I was thinking the whole time, this just made no fucking sense. And the match sucked as well. The match again between Barrett and fucking Cena blew, just like it did at the fucking pay-per-view. Okay? Whew. Complete bullshit. So, other than that, we got a new segment as well. This is a segment that I like to call the Fantasy Focus. This is where I like to take a segment in the show and rewrite it completely to what I think it should have been done. This is where Cena should have not been allowed to come back. Again, the promo was great. I mean, the best part about the promo, I have to mention, I mean, God, that was beautiful. All the women and kids, you know, say, let's go, Cena. And then all the men under the over the age of 18 say, Cena sucks. They kind of fucked it up at first. And Cena's like, oh, no, no, no. If we're going to do it, we're going to do it right. And that's what they're, that was awesome. I mean, the whole thing about, you know, payback's a bitch, and they bleeped it out. I mean, the fact about bringing up the mom, I mean, getting to see her for the, on her birthday for the first time in 10 years. Again, well played, Cena. I love the heartfelt promo. The problem is, it's all for naught, because that promo that you did tonight and the victory lap that you just did last night at Survivor Series, it's all, it means nothing now, because we already know what's going to happen here. We've seen it before with Stone Cold. We've seen it with The Rock. We've seen it, Bret Hart came back, okay? Cena's gonna come back, okay? He cost Wade Barrett his opportunity at the belt. So it only makes sense that now Wade Barrett's probably gonna lift his firing ban, which would make no sense as a fucking heel, just to get revenge at Cena. But no, 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 no. That's not how you book it, but that's where it's gonna go. This is how you would have booked it. Again, Cena does not come back. He is off TV. Wade Barrett still loses the match, okay? Difference is he loses by a disqualification, okay? Then after he's beat down, then the, oh, sorry, Orton's beat down, then after Nexus beats him down, bam! Miz comes in, does the same exact thing. I would have changed the thing there. That was perfect the way he came down and fucking cashed the money in the bank and won the match. But here's how you keep Cena off TV. You keep him off TV, let's say, until around the Royal Rumble. You have him in the Royal Rumble, but unlike last year, you have him lose. Be the second one to lose. Maybe have it between him and guess what? Wade Barrett. Wade Barrett's the one that actually eliminates John Cena, gets his WrestleMania match. But no, Cena gets to come back versus a you're fired versus a I will put up my WrestleMania main event match at No Way Out. Then you have that match at No Way Out to bring Cena back to beat Wade Barrett, to then again have Cena be put in the main event at WrestleMania. This way you get to see how your product goes for a couple months off TV, okay? Other than that, this has been a beautiful show. That's how I would have booked it. Let me know your thoughts. Let me know, you know, what you thought of my review. Peace out, guys. Take care.